CBS presents this program in color.
From Television City in Hollywood.
Red Skelton, our. Come along to a wax museum and you'll meet some people you know. Just as soon as you get to see them, we'll present the rest of the show. Here's our collection for your inspection, names up to date and the past. When you have your plants, we can all advance to some real life folks in the cast. Our guest stars, Bobby Darin.
Thank you very much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Before I got a joke. Gertrude and Heathcliff, the seagulls, see, they're talking. He says, well, sir, he says, I'm getting married right away. I got to get married or that Navy's going to draft me into the pigeon carrier corps. He says, you're a seagull, not a pigeon. He says, well, I could be an undercover agent. So they fly to Capistrano, see, as they fly into the little chapel, the old wise owl looked up and he says, well, look what the wind blew in. He says, it ain't the wind these days, buddy, it's the draft. Hey, you know, I had a lot of fun this summer. Dean Martin and myself, we took a little trip together, and we went up to the Grand Canyon, and he tried to fill it with beer cans. You know, everybody out in California, they have to drive themselves because there's no other forms of transportation, really, you know. And you should see some of the cars we have out here. The other night, I hit a trash can, and a guy stuck his head out, and he's... the guy stuck his head out, and he says, give me a little push, will you, buddy? I'm my battery's dead. And you know, the freeway's always so crowded nowadays. You know, when I was younger, I remember we had little roads called Lover's Lanes. You remember those things? Maybe that's why the freeways are so crowded now. You don't have any fun on the freeway because time you get anywhere, you're too tired to get anywhere. I remember one time I said to a girl, let's pause and look at the moon. She said, well, look at the moon. You keep your paws to yourself. Did you ever get stuck on the freeway and when there's a traffic jam, you know, the cars and traffic just barely moves, and there was some guy running alongside my car, and I'd slow down, he'd walk. And I'd go faster, he'd run again. Finally, I said, what are you doing? He says, I'm siphoning gas and I don't want the hose to break. What? I thought I heard somebody say that. Just laugh, don't make comments. You know, you see a lot of silly things on that freeway. Like the other day, I saw a lady driving a Mustang side saddle. And the other night, going down Hollywood Boulevard, there was a woman driving and she was making all kinds of signals like this, you know. And finally, I realized she wasn't making hand signals at all. She was putting on a spray deodorant. To my mother-in-law, she got one of those king-size sprays and went home and blew her arm off. But you know, I shouldn't talk about women drivers because, you know, if it wasn't for the women drivers, some men would never go to church. I remember when I was a kid, I had an electric car. It would only go about 3 or 4 blocks. That's all the further the car had reached. I went in the filling station one day, and you know how kids are. They drove in. I got this great big car, see? I go into the filling station and said, "Fill her up, 1 gallon.
The guy said, "What are you trying to do, buddy, wean it?"
But this old car, you know, you go 70 miles an hour, and it handed you a rabbit's foot. You go 80 miles an hour, and it would call for Dr. Kildare. 90 miles an hour, and St. Christopher got out. And at 100 miles an hour, the windshield turned into a stained glass window, and you heard, "Near my God to thee." Hey, did you ever get stuck in the traffic and have people in the back of you honk their horns? This happened to me one day, actually, right out in front of the studio when I was in radio years ago. There was my car stopped. See? The guy honked, and his horn kept honking and honking. Finally, I got out of my car, and I went back to him. I said, "Look, you go up and start the car, and I'll honk the horn for you." Hey, I would like to do a little pantomime if I could now, or if you don't mind. a little pantomime of a fellow that's stopped in the traffic and he's trying to get his car stalled and all the trouble. Can I borrow my hat? All the trouble that you have when your car stalls in traffic.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, our guest stars Bobby Darin and Jackie and Gayle with the Tom Hanson Dancers.
New York on Sunday, big city taking a nap. Slow down, it's Sunday, life's a ball, let it fall in your lap. And if you got trouble, go take them out for a walk. They'll burst like bubbles in the fun of a Sunday in New York. You can spend time without spending a dime watching people watch people pass. Later you're pausing in one of those stores. There's that face next to yours in the glass. Two hearts stop beating. You're both too breathless to speak. Love smiles a greeting, then the dream that has seen you through the week comes true on Sunday in New York.
Your favorite statue still standing out in the bay keeps winking at you and the ships that are passing every day.
Come on down to Coney. The rides are wonderful here.
upon a pony, you can pose for a cozy souvenir. People like us like to hop on a bus or a subway that's underground. You feel at home 'cause wherever you roam, there are millions of friends to be found. At night you take in a Broadway musical show. When dawn is breaking, you depart, but your heart will always know the thrill of Sunday in New York.
Up your satchel, then take a train or a jet.
We promise that you'll have a weekend you never will forget.
Why wait till Monday to start your fun day? Let's spend this Sunday in New York.
Tonight, Red Skelton as Sheriff Deadeye and Bobby Darin in The Fastest Crumb in the West.
Here's to Sheriff Deadeye, first sheriff in the West to die of fright.
How about another drink? To his memory.
That's a good idea.
Jake.
Yes, sir.
Give me a full
talk. All righty, here we go. Here you are.
Deadeye.
Yeah, Henry, Sheriff Deadeye.
Deadeye.
Yes, there he goes. Oh, here's one for you, Shorty. Deadeye.
What a disgrace. What a disgrace. Our sheriff, they were scared to death to learn that that gunfighter, the Arizona the Kid, was after him.
Poor old Deadeye. The Arizona Kid was just passing through town. He wasn't even gunning for him.
Well, how do you like that? Now, does anybody want to buy a used coffin? He's big enough for two if you care to go. Family plan. Well, I wait till I get the wise guy that stuck that lily in my navel. Boy, that was just in time. That thing started to grow roots.
Say, Charlie.
Yeah?
You have to pass Boot Hill. How about dropping the box off on your way home?
Oh, okay.
Good, good.
Wait a minute. Ain't anybody going to say anything nice about the dear old departed me? I mean, the dear old departed sheriff?
Well, now, let's see. Anybody got anything good to say about Sheriff Deadeye?
No. Deadeye was yellow-livered, yellow-bellied, and a yellow streak down his back.
Aren't you folks glad you got color sets?
I never knew Deadeye, personally. But I knew one good thing about him. He didn't believe in discrimination.
No, sir, I cheated him regardless of race, color, or creed.
Say, stranger, where did you get Sheriff Deadeye's badge?
Oh,
Where did you get Sheriff Deadeye's face?
Well, it's a set. It came with a badge.
Deadeye, you're alive.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, what a dirty trick to play on this town.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry that I ruined your day.
He's so crooked he can't even die straight.
Yeah. Oh, well, now, sir, I died the best I could. I got double-crossed in the reincarnation. I had to come back as myself.
You were just hiding because you were scared of the Arizona Kid.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, the Arizona Kid's coming back.
The Arizona Kid. Well, don't stand there. Throw me a lily, will you? Throw me a lily.
Get out of there.
You close that lid on my lily. You close the lid on my lily. Why did you close the lid on my lily?
Okay, get out of here.
A message with a knife in it.
Yeah, how about that? A letter with its own opener.
I think it's been a little bit lower. It could have been a people opener.
Deadeye, it's for you.
For me?
Yeah, it's from the Arizona Kid.
From the Arizona Kid.
Yeah, it says, it is beneath my dignity to kill a coward like you.
Well, now, that's mighty sweet of him. Mighty sweet, mighty sweet.
So I'm sending my grandmother to do it instead.
An old lady? Well, that don't seem fair. Now, she may be bigger than me.
Hey, here comes Granny now. Hi, Granny.
Hi, Granny. Get your hands up, Deadeye.
Oh, no, old woman. You ain't gonna spit in my hand.
This don't seem fair here. A granny goose fighting a chicken sheriff.
I'm gonna beat you within 1 inch of your life.
Well, how about a foot?
Gladly.
Oh, boy. I tell you, you know she's got muscles in that bustle?
Why don't you arrest her, Deadeye? She ain't got no respect for the law.
Well, she didn't kick the badge, did she? Now, I tell you, though, with that lump she's raised, I'm going to be mighty tall in the saddle.
You ain't worthy of wearing a sheriff's badge. I'm going to use this for a cookie cutter.
Yeah, well, I got news for you. Part of my chest is on that cookie cutter. And you're going to have some mighty hairy macaroons.
Deadeye, you ought to be ashamed of yourself letting a little old lady like that push you around. What are you going to do about it?
I'm ashamed. Only one thing to do, run myself out of town.
Run yourself out of town?
I'm the only guy I ain't afraid of. Out of town there, you.
We get well. Medicine man, come now.
Good morning, patients. I'm your friendly medicine man, Dr. Running Fever. Now, since you're all on the group medical plan, stick out your tongues and say ugh.
How you tell temperature that way?
It's simple. Take the total, and I divide by four. Now, either three of you have a very high fever, or one of you is dead.
That must be me. Don't feel so good.
Great. The next time you bite the dust, don't swallow it. What's your
case? I've been scalped!
Deadeye. We haven't scalped anybody for years.
Really?
Yes. And we still haven't. And we still haven't. You see, there it is. There it was. Keep it away from me.
Looks like I was caught in a hair raid, don't it, huh? Yes, sir. Even my hair's a coward. As soon as I saw an Indian, it went back into the skull. Here, run that for a touchdown.
Deadeye, are you here on business or are you score browsing?
No, I'll tell you, Doc. I've had a bad case of the shakes.
Or do you shake all over?
No, just when I'm in town.
I'll take you. What'd you do, lady?
I didn't do anything.
There must have been something as a crowd following.
You know, you got a loose papoose on your caboose, lady.
Doctor, you gotta do something. The babies keep crying all night.
Have you tried taking them off when you go to bed?
Maybe you better check their gas. You got enough there to fly to Pittsburgh.
I'll tell you what you do. You change their formula from coyote milk to porcupine milk.
How do you milk a porcupine?
Very carefully.
Well, I think I'll take your case now, Deadeye. Let's see. Take a deep breath.
Deep breath, huh?
Mm-hmm. And hold it. Hold it, now.
Hey, doctor, wait a minute. We here first.
Oh, yes, yes. I'll tell you what. I'll operate on the rest of all of you tomorrow.
Operate?
They don't call me Mac the Knife for nothing. You're dismissed. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Are you still holding your breath? Well, my professional medical advice is to let it go.
Okay, you can go on now.
What do you call that?
That's a rerun.
Now, tell me, then, when did you first notice that you were a coward?
When I was first born. Why, when the doctor tried to slap me, I ducked. And that ain't easy when you're hanging upside down. I was 5 years before I knew I wasn't a bat.
Fortunately, my tribe has a very special cure for cowardice.
Oh?
It's called Indian Brave Juice.
Indian Brave Juice? Oh, I wouldn't want you to squeeze out an Indian just for me.
Don't worry about it, Deadeye. Now, these are my assistants.
Yeah?
Yes. This is Running Cloud, and this is Running Water.
Boy, if I was built like that, I'd do a little running myself.
If you were built like that, your card would be filled at every rain dance.
Yeah. Well, so long, kids. As soon as I get a little courage, I'll call you. I'll bet they've got an unlisted smoke signal, though.
Now, it's Deadeye.
Do they really get anything on those antennas?
Deadeye, I'm the doc. Pay attention, I'm the doc.
You're the doc. Could I have a glass of water?
I don't have any water.
Oh, a dry doc, huh?
The first thing you have to do in order to make a successful
break. You know, I'm a doc, too.
You are? What
kind? Yeah, we're a paradox. Very slowly.
First thing you need in order to make grape juice,
yes,
is one level cup of panther drool.
Well, how do you get a panther to drool?
You show him a picture of a girl panther.
Well, I'll tell you, I may not have a tiger in my tank, but I'm going to have a panther in my pot.
Next thing is very important.
Yeah.
You must take and put into this mix one egg from a reindeer.
An egg from a reindeer?
Naturally. Now, wait a minute. Aren't you going to ask me how you get an egg from a reindeer?
Well, it's obvious. You wait till the reindeer leaves the icebox and you raid it.
Who do you want to play?
That's the way.
Tell you, I didn't think you knew, did I? Here, now.
That last one there.
You got to stir it up.
That chicken must have been going with a Mexican rooster.
Going here. Now, it's very important that you pour it in, and then you stir it up. Now, drink that. No, wait. Got a better one for you. Try this.
Oh, we forgot. We forgot to tell you. We changed that.
Oh, I see. I'm glad you forgot to tell me. It didn't matter much anyway. Now, you drink that, and you'll get rid of the yellow streak up your back.
Well, I couldn't do that. Not the yellow streak. That's the only thing holding my pants up.
You know, that's the first time I've ever drunk lumpy water.
It's my fault. I didn't stir it.
I'll stir it. Well, welcome to the gallstone of go-go.
At the sound of the chimes, you will be brave.
I will?
Yes.
The NBC Chimes?
we mention another network, say you gotta be brave.
You think that's something? Wait till you break out in peacock feathers.
Say, Sheriff Deadeye's coming back from the Indian village.
I heard he drank some of that brave juice, and he ain't a coward no more.
Nothing's gonna help Deadeye. He's afraid of his own shadow.
Who's afraid of his own shadow? You missed.
Ham, he'll have his own series next season.
Say, Sheriff,
yeah? It's about time this town got a good sheriff.
Yeah, now the law can really be enforced. Yeah.
You dang right it can, and I'm starting off by fining you $10 for talking back to the sheriff.
Talking back to the sheriff?
You see, you did it again. Now that's $20 fine.
I ain't got no money.
Okay, then I'm gonna arrest you for vagrancy. Here, this off. And here, you can take her with you.
What for?
She ain't got no lines. Get her out of here. Must be his latest record. Say, Ringo. What is that, a war dance?
No, these moccasins are killing me.
Running fever, I'm fining you $10.
Oh, I hope you find it real quick, because I can use it.
No, I'm fining you $10.
For what?
For General Custer's birthday. We're taking up a collection for his window. His widow. Well, it's the same thing. When you're near a widow or a window, look out, you know.
I'm your friend, did I?
I know that.
I'm so much of a friend, I even gave you the sheriff's discount on your brave juice.
Well, if you was a real friend, you'd tear it up.
Okay. I will. There it is.
$10 fine for being a litter bug.
We Indians should never have trusted people like you. Because the fact that we did proves that we no longer have whatever that line says on that card. In fact, if we had trusted people like you, we'd still have Manhattan.
Yeah, and you'd be stuck with a world's fair. High and dry. Now, give me the $10.
Deadeye?
What's the matter?
I tell you, I got a confession. Soggy moccasins are killing me. Deadeye, we got no money.
Yeah?
All us Indians spent all our money trying to fight John Wayne.
Now, you're fibbing through your feathers. That sounds like a lot of setting bull to me. Now, you're standing pat, and I know it.
You have the nerve to accuse an Indian of being dishonest?
Well?
I challenge you to a shootout at high noon.
I'll drink to that. And if I ain't high by noon, you can start without me.
Howdy, folks. And welcome to the shootout of the week. Yeah. That's the courtesy of our local undertaker. Yay!
Deadeye, I'm gonna fill you full of arrows. You're gonna have so many arrows sticking out of you, they're gonna have to pluck you before they bury you.
I'm gonna fill you so full of holes that you'll have to find your navel from memory.
I'm gonna put so many arrows through you. Why, yeah, you look like you're a bunch of weather vanes.
I'm gonna fill you so full of holes, you're gonna have 20 new places to put your peace pipes.
Now, come on, fellas, let's cut the gabbing. Now, let's get on with the killing.
Yeah, are you scared, Deadeye?
No, sir, I'm full of brave juice, I am. Ain't nothing in the world scares me.
Well, that brave juice just happens to wear off at 12 noon.
Yeah. Well, that scares me a little.
Well,
choreography by Tom Hansen. Yeah, I'm as brave as a lion. I'm as strong as a lion. I gotta get home. I'm beginning to smell like a lion. I'm a lion, but somehow I'm beginning to feel like a pussycat. Why, it must be high noon. High noon. I just remembered. I left the water running.
Where?
In Niagara Falls.
Come back. Did I?
Yeah.
I'm gonna show you what real bravery is.
Yeah?
Yes, sir. I'm gonna let you shoot first.
Well, now that is brave. That is brave. Dumb, but brave. See, you have a good eye. Well, now that's real movie style. I got three with one bullet. Yeah. Hey, how come you're still alive?
I figured with your aim, Deadeye, the safest place was right in front of you.
Well, we can't shoot each other.
Well, how come not?
Well, because there'd be nobody left to bury us. Yeah, I'll tell you what. To be sure that you get a nice funeral, I'm going to shoot you myself. And then I can bury you.
Well, that's darn nice of you.
Yeah? I miss you again. Die's kind of slow, you know.
One of them Indians lost the West. You can talk them into anything.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like for you to meet our guest star, a fine actor and a very talented singer, Mr. Bobby Darin. Thank you, Bobby.
Pleasure.
Say, you know what I like best about your singing?
What's that?
Is the way you snap your fingers.
Oh, you like that, huh?
Yeah. Why do you do that so loud? So you don't have to hear yourself sing?
Thanks a lot. As a matter of fact, I enjoy it. You see, when I was in school, in high school, I won a finger snapping championship.
Really?
Yeah, I flunked all my grades, but got an A in thumb.
You know, I used to be a great finger snapper myself.
No.
Oh, yeah. Every night, my family used to rush into the room. They thought there was a crap game going on in the crib. See, would you like to make a little wager?
About what? Sure.
Well, I'll bet you $10 that I can snap my fingers louder than you can.
You got a bet.
All right, sir.
I go first.
Yeah, go ahead. Oh, now, you didn't do that all day, that other one.
I want to throw it.
Well, it did, now. Here, watch this. Watch, like, mumble peg. All of them.
I think I broke my wrist. $10.05 for your buddy upstairs. He's working with you, isn't he?
Yeah.
I tell you, the real secret and the real test is to see if you can do the same thing. Snap your fingers with gloves on.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Now,
I'll
bet
get
you
some
$50
gloves.
On that.
$50 on this one. I'll get the gloves.
No, you don't have to. Oh, no. I come very well prepared. Happen to have a pair myself right here.
Really?
Just slip them on. If you don't mind, I'll go first. Okay?
Go ahead.
Just warming up, pal. Just warming up.
Well, give me the other glove.
Oh, certainly. If you don't mind, I'll take the glove back. Thank you. I'm not mad or anything, but you see, this is a very favorite glove of mine. It was made in Japan.
Really? I got news for you. That money was made in Japan, too. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Darin, Jackie and Gayle, and the Tom Hansen Dancers with the Alan Copeland Singers.
there's an air about her, something so square about her, that makes you care about her more than you should. First that funny feeling, then the warm comes on, a dull familiar love before the storm comes on. The inconceivable becomes achievable, it's unbelievable what you can do. When that funny feeling touches you, and she has got that funny feeling too. That funny feeling that puts such demands on you, better never let her get her hands on you. The inconceivable becomes achievable, it's unbelievable what you can do. Once that funny feeling touches you,
lollipops and rainbows, everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together. Brighter than a lucky penny when you're near, the raindrops disappear, dear, and I feel so fine just to know that you are mine. My life is sunshine, lollipops and rainbows, that's how this street rain goes, so come on, join in. Everybody's sunshine, lollipops and rainbows, everything that's wonderful is sure to come your way, 'cause love is here to stay.
The Silent Spot, starring Red Skelton as the millionaire yachtsman.
Ha ha ha!
Don't go away. Red will be back in a minute. Here he is again, Red Skelton.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of our sponsors and staff, we sincerely hope that we've brought one second of happiness into your home. It certainly has been 1 hour of happiness for us. So until next week, I'll say goodbye for now, and may God bless. Good night.
We regret that it's necessary to remove our fancy display. Strike the jokes and the statuary till we meet a week from today. So goodbye until the moment when we'll see you all again. To our friends near and far, fare thee well, au revoir.
Wax figures courtesy of the Hollywood Wax Museum. This is Art Gilmore speaking.